Some of you probably know tables like this in which an interpretation of p-values is given. But when you have really bad data, the table ends where it begins to get interesting. So I extended this table a bit. If you have a p-value greater than 0.9, you have two options. Either we evaluate live values or then the p-value. And the latter is what I'm going to do now. So I want to explain why the p-value and null hypothesis significance tests are not great. And this is not something I've been making up, but actually there's a debate about null hypothesis significance tests ever since Fisher, Neyman and Pearson have developed them. One objection against null hypothesis significance tests is that they are difficult to understand and often misinterpreted. So I first want to show a study that was conducted in 6 German universities. The participants, who were psychology students, researchers and statistic instructors, got the following tasks. Task. Suppose you have a treatment that you suspect may alter performance on a certain task. You compare the means of your control and experimental group. Further, suppose you use a simple independent means t-test and your result is significant. Please mark each of the statements below as true or false. False means that the statement does not follow logically from the above premises. Also note that several or none of the statements may be correct. You have absolutely disproved the null hypothesis. You have found the probability of the null hypothesis being true. You have absolutely proved your experimental hypothesis. You can deduce the probability of the experimental hypothesis being true. You know, if you decide to reject the null hypothesis, the probability that you are making the wrong decision. You have a reliable experimental finding in the sense that if, hypothetically, the experiment were repeated a great number of times, you would obtain a significant result on 99% of occasions. So it turns out that all the statements are false. However, most of the participants thought that at least one of the statements were correct. So I will first give a short overview why the statements are false and then explain in more detail. Statement 1 and 3 are false because null hypothesis significance tests can't prove or disprove hypotheses. For statement 2 and 4 it is similar. It's not possible to make an assertion about the probability of the null or the alternative hypothesis with null hypothesis significance tests. Statement 5 might sound like the type 1 error rate, but it isn't. And statement 6 is called the replication fallacy. So why isn't it possible to make statements about the probability of the null or the alternative hypothesis with null hypothesis significance tests? One form of valid deductive logical reasoning is the modus tollens. An example would be the following. If the null hypothesis is correct, then this datum cannot occur. It has, however, occurred. Therefore, the null hypothesis is false. As I said, this is valid reasoning. But in statistics, you always handle with probabilities, so that would then be, if the null hypothesis is correct, then these data are highly unlikely. These data have occurred. Therefore, the null hypothesis is highly unlikely. And that would not be valid anymore. You can easily see that it isn't when you look at an example. If a person is an American, then he is probably not a member of Congress. This person is a member of Congress. Therefore, he's probably not an American. So why is this argument not valid? According to Bayes' theorem, the probability of the hypothesis given the data and the probability of the data given the null hypothesis is not the same. With the p-value, we only know the probability of the data, or more extreme values, given the null hypothesis is 2. To get from there to the probability of the null given the data, we would also need to know the probability of the null and the probability of the data. Unfortunately, there isn't even a correlation between these two probabilities. So with that, we can say that the first four statements are false. But why isn't P or alpha the type 1 error rate? The reason is similar. The type 1 error rate is the probability that the null hypothesis is true given its rejection. One cannot make a type 1 error when the null hypothesis is false or when it is not rejected. Alpha, on the other hand, is the probability that one will reject the null given it is true. For any statistical test, we do not know if the null is true or not, but the type 1 error can only occur in cases in which it is true, so alpha sets an upper bound to the first type error rate. The replication fallacy is similar again. With the p-value, we have the probability of the data given the null hypothesis is true. We don't have the probability of replication given the data. Lots of influences determine whether or not it is possible to replicate a result. Oakes calculated that for an experiment with a significant result and a typical power value of 50, the chances that in 5 replications, as many as 3 of them were significant are only 50-50. So with that, we can say that the 5th and the 6th statement are false as well. But there are more objections against the null hypothesis significance test. For example, that often null hypotheses are used as null hypothesis. Null hypothesis describes hypotheses that are known to be false because the effects in two groups are only different in a tiny bit. So the question that is answered with significance tests is if the sample size was big enough to detect the difference. Another objection is that null hypothesis significance tests present research findings as clear-cut when there is no reason to make a sharp categorization into significant and non-significant based on an arbitrary p-value. The p-value is also arbitrary because in case of null hypothesis, it is possible to get any desired p-value by just increasing the sample size. So all you have to do is test enough subjects against a null hypothesis, like it is often done. These are not all objections against null hypothesis significance tests, but I think it's enough for now. I can make a second edition or discuss in the comments if there's interest. So thank you for watching, and I'd like to hear your opinion in the comments.